The bicycle one.
Yes, it's the bicycle one.
I know how to say that word. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Last left off on... Oh, let me press the B button. The Hexagon of Fear. Are you recording?
Yes.
Oh! Hi, everybody!
Hi. I'm going to... Oh, yeah, Hexagon of Fear was the last one we did.
Yeah.
That's...
Time for Log Rail! Oh, we didn't make it to 35 last
time? We should have done this one last time.
You guys get a special 6 level bonus episode!
Apparently we... Yeah, if we have that much time,
Woo!
I press B again. Let's do Ladybug.
Like. Okay.
Let's do Ladybug.
It's nice and easy. Let's do this. Toy World. Log Rail. Roll. Rail. That's a rail. Okay.
I mean, do you think I should believe the ball select screen that the Ladybug is nice and easy? I mean, it could be really mean and easy.
Good point.
You know, it could be insulting all the other marbles, like, all the time.
I would believe that. Because this guy's, like, the mascot, kind of this game, so I could see him just being like, none of you guys get your marble on the title. I do.
Or, you know, maybe, like, constantly frustrated and easy.
Oh.
Because even though it's easy to control, it exists in this horrible world.
Oh, but it's so happy and playful and toy-filled.
Alright. Oh no!
I'm kind of happy that I grew up in a generation that didn't have these toys. Because honestly, like, action figures and video games are so much cooler than, like, wooden horses.
That's why they were invented, but,
I want that robot.
I was gonna say, like, any people who grew up with that stuff will be nostalgic for it, and some of those people who are nostalgic for it will say that it's better than today's kids' toys. But, then it occurred to me, what generation of people are the generation that had that?
I have no idea.
I'm not sure.
I think that's kind of just like a generalization of what kids play with.
Like, the generation come on, again? With that? With me not going over there correctly?
Oh, man.
Yeah, for all we know, the people who actually had that stuff when they were kids are, like, dead now.
Yeah.
Of old age.
Well, this isn't even like a kid's room. This is like a toy heaven place.
I'm pretty sure some houses have like toy rooms. They're really rich people.
Yeah,
houses,
like rich people houses.
They exist.
The people that have like 7 bathrooms.
Yeah,
that's one of the things they say, right? Like that you'll be selling a house and it's like it has 7 bathrooms, and you're like, man, I can poop 7 places at once.
No, you can't.
But that's why you have 7, right?
You know that one drill tweet, I think, that's like, my bathroom has 99 fake toilets and 1 real toilet.
Oh. Oh, but like, what happens if you use a fake one? Does it just burst into confetti?
I don't know. It's... what kind of purpose would that have?
You go up a staircase of blocks, but once you finally try to poop in the toilet, booze burst out of it and laugh.
Yeah. That would be terrible. I mean, imagine if you really had to use the bathroom and you had no idea which toilet was the right one.
I think if that house is big enough, you could probably let it slide in a corner or something and no one would know.
But is it? How do you know it's not a tiny house with a huge bathroom?
Oh god, I don't know, that's weird. I don't know,
yeah.
But obviously, like, I wouldn't be too worried, because with the ability to poop in 7 toilets at once, you can find the real one quickly. Hey, I remember this level.
Oh, it's reverse now. This isn't good.
This is the Saturn level. You guys love Saturn.
Oh, no.
Well, yeah, I remember you guys playing with Saturn. You enjoyed it a lot.
I remember that as well. And it's, other gems up there that I need to get?
Yes.
Oh. Okay. It would have been cool if I could have just skipped that.
I believe you can press A to restart the level.
I'm gonna collect some of the other gems around.
Alright. Whoa!
Oh, but not that one, I guess.
Yeah, I guess not. Yeah, there's that one, too.
Yeah, that's right, like, I was expecting the level to be...
Oh, but that is your phone.
Yeah. Hold on a second.
We're back, folks.
How do I pause the game? B is paused. So, last time we learned that B is paused, not plus.
Yeah. We were. Are you kidding?
Really?
Okay, cut again!
Well, it should be like an 800 number or something. No, it's my dad again.
Oh my god.
Hello. Yes? I think you butt dialed me.
Jesus, really? It only happens when we're recording. Whatever, it's funny, right? Okay, we're back. Hopefully for realsies this time.
But I'm not ending the levels for real. Nope.
Mm-hmm.
Cause I still gotta cut.
Gotta get past that first part.
You see what I'm trying to do?
Yeah,
right?
I understand the thought process here. Oh no!
Well, I mean, I did it, but
you died. You died from impact, even though you can fly.
Did you see that? Yeah, like I died. I like poofed into death on the ground.
That buttercup must be holding you back from your true potential as a flying insect.
No. Moving platform in the screen.
So I know we just got interrupted by two phone calls, but your laptop is yelling at us that its battery is low.
Oh, I should probably fix that. Let's pause again.
Cut again!
Gotta make sure the laptop stays on, because without that, we wouldn't be recording this episode. And then what would you do? Not watch this episode?
Exactly. You're already watching this episode, but if this laptop wasn't on, then you wouldn't be watching this episode.
Yeah. You'd be watching a different episode where we would be redoing the same things and complaining about how we had to redo things.
Yeah, really.
Speaking of complaining about redoing things, I don't like this.
You can do it. I believe in you. You've done harder levels.
Not in a while.
Oh, good point. You're a bit out of practice.
I don't know, I'm disoriented by the fact that it's reverse too, which I'm sure is the intended purpose of reversing things. But
well, it's just like
tough.
A different level. You know, it's the
I know, but
level,
like,
but
I remember things about the level,
okay.
And they're different, they're reversed.
Yeah, alright.
Hey,
I did it.
Is this the only gem that's up here?
Maybe.
So, now if I want to, I can just...
Well, I bet the last gem was... Wow, okay. That was some Skittles right there.
Right.
Oh, I like it. Good job.
That was a good end.
That was professional. You should have gotten a trophy for skills.
I agree.
It would have an SZ on it. Skills.
SZKILLSZ.
Yes.
Skills.
This is a long level if I remember correctly, but this time it's backwards.
So what's my KD ratio on this game? Yeah.
But I'm trying to calculate how many cats you've killed. It's probably not good. I don't know. I mean, you've died lots, but also every time you've died, most of those times you've killed a small round animal.
That's true.
Or a dude named Charlie. So.
But is Charlie not considered a small round animal?
Well, he's a...
Well, he's at least a small animal, because he's small enough to be able to fit into all these marble-sized places.
Good point, yeah. So he's not round, though, because he's just kind of in the ball.
What about that time that I was, like, a bunch of cars? Was there a small round animal inside the cars?
Nah, I think they were just dead. I think, actually, in that episode, we talked about, like, what if there are people in there and they're just hating life right now?
We also talked a lot about dinosaurs.
Oh yes. We did talk a lot about dinosaurs.
Yeah, you remember that?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think we know what we're gonna do there.
Yeah, I think I know what you want me to do. I don't know if I'm actually gonna do it.
Aw, but it's a running joke. Whatever.
Now, I just have to focus on the opposite of dinosaurs, which naturally is collecting gems.
Oh,
okay. Some dinosaurs couldn't collect gems because...
I thought you were going to be like, I have to focus on the opposite of dinosaurs, which is like rats or something.
No, see, the opposite of dinosaurs is collecting gems because dinosaurs couldn't collect gems because they didn't have any dinosaur miners to mine into the ground and collect gems.
Their arms were too tiny to hold pickaxes.
Either that or, you know, they didn't have arms, you know, like the Stegosaurus.
Oh.
It's a little known fact, but Stegosaurus actually didn't have arms.
That's profiling. You don't know. They could have just lost the arm skeleton bones. For all you know, Stegosaurus could be the exact same, but it has arms coming out of the side.
With no bones in them?
No, it has. They have bones, but sometimes fossils aren't perfect.
So...
It's like a centaur. But only the arms.
It's basically like arms coming out of a neck.
No, it's like the middle of the body.
Oh.
See? It's a stegatar.
No. A centosaurus.
Yeah.
That would be a dinosaur that has 100 legs.
100 dinosaurs. It's a dinosaur that is 100 dinosaurs.
Well, 100 is something. It doesn't have to be legs.
Yeah. It could be,
It could be...
Scales?
Eyes?
Oh, God.
A dinosaur with 100 eyes?
Oh, Jesus. That's terrifying. It could have 100, tails.
It could
It'll be perfectly balanced.
It could have 100 wheels.
Oh.
Maybe it's a dinosaur that,
invented
the wheel. Before cavemen, and then cavemen discovered
cavemen
wheels
stole it.
From the dinosaurs.
I like that. 100 wheels.
Yeah.
Take that, trucks.
Yeah.
16 wheels ain't shit.
The Centosaurus got you.
Uh-huh. Eat it.
Hmm.
You think you're cool because you have 18 wheels? There's a dinosaur that did that before you, bro. Except he had, like...
No, wait.
Way more.
See, the Centosaurus, like... The Centosaurus was like a really long dinosaur.
Oh no!
Because it had so many wheels.
Oh.
Right. It was also probably like not only long but also wider, and there were some wheels in the middle.
Right. Oh,
I guess.
Okay. I was thinking like you're gonna be like, you know, the vestigial appendage that people think were legs on snakes is actually wheel spokes.
No. See, the Centosaurus is the only dinosaur to survive the extinction of the rest of the dinosaurs.
Ah.
And that's where cavemen, you know, got the idea for like a wheel from looking at them. But then they did eventually die, but instead of putting their skeletons into a museum, you know, like all the other dinosaur skeletons,
right.
They just turned their skeletons into trucks. That's what trucks are.
Oh.
They're Centosaurus skeletons.
That's terrifying. I can't look at a truck the same way again though.
Yeah.
Also, you can get in your truck and be like, "Chia!" And then it'll roar and breathe fire. And that's what dinosaurs do.
Well, no, I like the idea. You know how trucks have like a rope and you pull it and it honks instead of like a button on the wheel.
Oh yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Totally.
I like, you know, doing that, but instead of a honking sound, it's like a dinosaur roar.
Oh jeez, that's terrifying, actually. Except, what if it was a herbivore and then it just like dino moves?
I think there were probably some herbivore dinosaurs who, like, made a scary sound to scare off other things that might eat it or something.
Point, probably. We don't know what they sounded like, though, because they are dead.
Speaking of dead, would you like to play the game?
Sure.
Thanks.
Sure. Alright. I am playing the game now.
Yeah. You're playing the game now.
Yes. Look at me. Yeah. I am playing the game.
See... Whenever I say, like, you know, Porkchips is the one holding the controller now, I don't say that for the audience's benefit, because the audience can see it on the screen, like, with the little picture of the thing.
Do you say it as an editing cue?
I say it for my own benefit, so I know when to change the picture of the thing to the other character on screen.
I got the checkpoint. Wait, what?
You don't have enough gems.
Oh. Did you not get the one over here?
No.
You didn't.
Okay.
The checkpoint looks so full when it gets like that.
What do you mean? Like,
it's so not full, and then it gets that, like, amazing, really bold, black marker line.
Yeah, well, when it's not... when you don't have enough gems for it, it's just, like...
Oh, no, there's not a wall there. I have died.
When you don't have enough gems for it, it's just, like, sketched onto the ground, like, with chalk or something.
Yeah.
And then it actually looks real once you can use it. Oh, you're going up instead of down. I know mirroring the levels is confusing, but gravity is still the same, usually.
I missed one. Hold on.
Wait, where?
Because I skipped part of the level.
Oh.
I'm gonna go on a trek.
A trek through toy trek.
There we go. Toy trek.
Yeah. The cat's playing with colored pencils on the table.
Oh yes, it is.
I don't know if that sound was picked up by the microphone here.
Yes. As long as he doesn't try to eat that pumpkin. That's cool.
There's a pumpkin here. Do you know why?
Because you're about to make pie.
No, it's because this video may or may not be our Halloween spooktacular.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Okay, now I have the controller back.
Yeah. This is why you're getting a full 6 levels.
Indeed.
That's 6 more levels than you would have gotten if you didn't watch this video.
Okay, Forkshifts, I want you right now to say Halloween Spooktacular in a really dramatic voice.
It's the Halloween Spooktacular! Second?
Yeah, that was great.
Sweet.
If this video, like, if we end up, like, actually recording on Halloween or something, like I kind of wanted to, then let's, like, play that clip at the beginning of that video.
Oh, yeah. Alright. It's weird.
Spoilers.
Oh no, spoilers. Just bleep that out. Bleep that out with a truck horn.
Okay. You mean a Centaurus
yes.
horn?
Yes, exactly.
Actually, I mean it's a little known fact, but truck horns are the sound that Centaurus has made.
Meh.
The sound actually came from their bones and not vocal cords.
Oh god, okay. I like the idea of a bunch of dinosaurs all eating in a clearing, and then, like, a T-Rex comes up, and it roars, and it's like, roar! I can't think of T-Rex or whatever. But, like, it roars, and it scares all the herbivores, and then all the herbivores do their little, like, trumpet thing to warn each other, and
yes.
It's just like, roar! You know, dinosaur roars, and then in the middle of that, just, like, rush hour traffic car horning, because of the Centaurus's.
Yeah, imagine a herd of Centaurus. Like,
it just sounds like rush hour.
A herd of, you know, Centauruses, and then a T-Rex was coming up on them, and they just all honked, like, really loudly. No. Imagine how spooked the T-Rex would be.
The T-Rex would just be like, I ain't having that shit, yeah. Nobody. Get the fuck away from me, I'm gonna go eat a pterodactyl.
Yeah. Or a pterodactyl, which, but actually, it's a little known fact, but it's not actually a dinosaur pterodactyl.
Oh, yeah.
That's true. Unlike some other things we've said, that's actually true. Pterodactyls are actually pterosaurs, yeah. Which are different than dinosaurs.
Didn't we give, a full minute of false information on plesiosaurs?
I don't remember. It's possible.
Yeah. Just in case you guys didn't know, plesiosaurs are very small dinosaurs, and they have 4 dragonfly-like wings that stick out of their potato body. And they drink nectar from the blood of your enemies.
So plesiosaurs are like bounty hunter dinosaurs? Like they're hired so they can drink from other people's enemies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you have to say please.
I'm going to Photoshop that.
Okay. Please do. It sounds amazing.
It does. Oh no. Hopefully it will look just as amazing.
Mm-hmm. Depending.
Yeah.
Picture pending. Well.
Patent pending.
Yeah. Well, we don't have any patents.
We may or may not copyright the plesiosaur.
Oh, but can we do that? Wouldn't a dinosaur fact book have that or something? Or are dinosaurs public domain?
Yeah. What. That's not a question you can... that question doesn't make sense. Like, I mean, what are there other... Are any other animal public domain? Like, is a chicken public domain?
I don't know, are they?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, technically, I don't think it's actually stated anywhere whether or not they are, which means that they are.
Okay, cool. So dinosaurs are public domain.
Yeah.
Cool. That means we can use all the dinosaurs we want. Like, Velociraptor. And...
Which Velociraptor? Like the Jurassic Park one or like the real one?
Both.
Okay.
Yeah. And then, the...
Oh, no, no. Stop telling me I'm okay, corner of the screen. I'm clearly not okay.
I'm trying to think of dinosaur names. I don't know any. Well, I used to know a ton. The Diegosaurus.
The okay
source. The cousin of Dorosaurus.
Yeah.
The Pachycephalosaurus.
I don't know.
That's a dinosaur.
I don't even know what I was. I wanted to say something clever like a joke there, but I didn't actually think of anything to say.
Alright.
You see that robot down there? Oh. Like, breakdancing on the floor? You can't see it right now because it's behind me, but you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, the robot that starred in, like, the last few episodes.
It's actually a Robosaurus.
Oh, Robosaurus, gotcha.
It's a time-traveling dinosaur?
Yeah. He travels by furiously seizuring. He's doing it right now, see?
Whoa! Yeah. I like the idea that there's a time-traveling dinosaur. That didn't go extinct because it just time traveled away.
Well, I mean, it would die eventually unless it's like a special dinosaur.
Mm-hmm.
It has like two dinosaur hearts or something.
Yeah. So a dinosaur lord.
Mm-hmm. Oh yes, definitely.
Yeah. let me ask you something. Have you ever eaten a dinosaur?
No, I've never inserted car oil into my mouth.
That was a trick question. The answer was yes.
Oh.
You have eaten a dinosaur.
Oh, I have?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot. It was a lot quieter than I thought it would be.
Because, oh, hold on. I was about to explain why you've eaten a dinosaur.
Right.
But I have to actually concentrate on this game right now,
yeah,
please.
Yeah, sure.
If I can just make
Ooh,
it here. Nice.
Alright.
So.
Oh, you're okay.
Oh, okay.
You're very okay. In fact, that okay is pulsing so much,
yeah. You
couldn't not be okay.
Actually, that seems like it might be a problem. I think that okay should see a doctor.
I don't know. I think he's having fun.
That doesn't mean it's... Just because he's having fun doesn't mean it's good for him.
Aww.
I mean, haven't you ever heard of drugs?
No. Please enlighten me on what drugs are.
Well, you see, drugs used to be alive during the dinosaur age.
Oh god, okay.
But then, when the dinosaur meteor hit, you know, they stopped being shaped like a dinosaur and started being shaped like drugs.
Gotcha.
And, you know, we still find their fossils today in the forms of, you know, marijuana leaves and such like. And, that's why you've eaten a dinosaur.
But why are they bad for me, though?
Did you not get what I just...
I just
called you someone who uses drugs. How do you feel about that?
I don't know why they're bad for me. Yeah. Nobody has told me why drugs are bad.
Well, I mean, they're dinosaurs. Like,
oh.
I mean, it's the same reason you people don't like to eat cats. I mean,
you could.
I mean, you don't though. It's just not something that you should do.
But I mean, like, you could.
Yeah, but
it wouldn't be bad for you.
No, but it's morally wrong.
But what if I want to eat drugs?
It's morally wrong, and that's the problem.
Okay. I won't eat drugs because of morals.
Oh,
it's this level backwards. It's actually very different.
Yes.
The other way around.
Yes. Really, though, this is true. What I'm about to say.
Right.
Is that, the real reason that you have eaten a dinosaur is that birds evolved from dinosaurs.
Oh, yes.
And because the way science distinctions between things that are evolved, like, technically birds should still be called dinosaurs.
Right.
So if you've eaten, like, chicken, then you've eaten a dinosaur.
Oh, dinosaurs are delicious. What's so wrong about eating them, then? Everybody does it. I want to do it, Mom. I want to eat drugs.
Drugosaurus.
This is Drugosaurus Rex. That means King Drugosaurus.
King.
That's what Rex means.
King Drug.
Whoa. Oh my king god, that drugs. Scared me so much.
I know, I would also be afraid of the King of Drugs.
No. Well, okay, so here's the story, right? Your cat just walked up behind me.
Yeah.
But like, she was probably just waving her tail around, but she walked up behind me and put her tail like on my neck in a way that it felt like like something furry was like touching my neck. Like not just one point, like actually wrapping around, and I got super spooked.
Hmm.
Which makes sense, because it's so close to Halloween! Oh god. It's a good thing neither one of your cats is very black.
Well, one of them is mostly dark.
Kind of dark, yes. It's like stripy though.
Oh, I fell in a hole.
Aw, you fell in the plates that are really good to eat off of.
Yeah, don't you just want to eat off of these plates so much?
Yes.
I mean, they're made of wood and have holes
delicious.
In them.
I want to eat those gems.
Because
what if they're just really good cheese?
yeah. They're from the moon.
Oh.
Because the moon is made of cheese.
Not Wisconsin?
Or... Well, yeah, it's... Oh. You know, scientists have been debating about whether or not Wisconsin is on the moon.
Oh, gotcha.
We're not sure. It might be on the moon, it might be on Earth. We haven't determined that yet.
Okay, yeah.
If it is on the Earth, though, it's a pretty amazing coincidence there, because their geographies are very similar.
You know what I always get mixed up, actually?
What?
Ohio and Idaho, which one makes potatoes?
Idaho.
Exactly. I always... Whenever someone's like, oh, I'm from Ohio,
no.
Maybe you could fling yourself back up or die trying. Okay, probably not.
Okay.
But I've had a few times in my life where someone's been like, I'm from Ohio, and I'm like, how are the potatoes? And they're like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Do you know where Ohio is on the map of America?
Kind of in the middle and up.
Yeah, it's kind of like up and... And to the right, but not, like, totally to the right.
Yeah.
It's kind of... Yeah.
I don't... No, I don't actually know a very good way of describing it. I think I know where it is. You should bring it up on a map. Educate all the kiddos at home right where Ohio is and put a big potato on it. No, put that on Idaho.
Sure.
Put something from Ohio on Ohio.
What's from Ohio? Are there any celebrities that were born in Ohio?
Probably.
I'll look that up.
Yeah. Put a good old picture of a celebrity's face from Ohio on Ohio.
Yeah. Are there any... You know what? No. I was just gonna say something that, like, that I could also Photoshop onto that image, but it would actually be a lot of work and I'd rather not do it, so I'm not gonna say what I was gonna say.
Alright. I'll ask you about it, post amazing recording.
Okay. How long have we been recording for?
A while, actually.
It's been like...
This is the Halloween... well, not Halloween
spectacular. 30 minutes. This is the Halloween spooktacular episode. It's been half an hour.
You get an extra level.
What level are we on right now? What number, I mean?
I don't know.
39.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, but I was going to say we might want to like split up videos because it's getting long, but no, we can finish.
Yeah, it'll just be like a 35-minute video, probably.
I hope.
Unless we're awful. Unless we're both collectively awful, because if you're awful, then you can switch it over to me, and hopefully I'm less awful. And neither one of us is full awful.
Remember what I was saying earlier about the moon, and how it was made of cheese, and how these gems are from the moon, because they're cheese?
Delicious, yes.
Well, it's a little known fact, but there actually was a type of dinosaur. It's called the Cheezosaurus.
Cheezosaurus.
And it was the only dinosaur not to be extinct by the...
Again
with that. So, yeah.
It's like Stegosaurus, but all the little plates are cheese.
Yeah, see, the Cheezosaurus you know, like the centaur and the time-traveling dinosaur was the only dinosaur to survive the extincting of the dinosaurs. And the reason it survived is because the meteor, the dinosaur meteor that hit, was...
melted all of them, and that's why notches exist.
Well, that too. Like that's true as well. But what I was going to say was that the meteor that hit actually was the moon.
Oh.
And since the moon is made of cheese, you know, the Cheetosaurus were obviously immune to that.
Wow, that level took 6 minutes. We're really talking about dinosaurs lately. last episode, not last episode, was it?
I think it was, it might have been.
Last episode we just kept flashing dinosaurs at people, and now it's like, you can't stop talking about dinosaurs, help.
Yeah, actually.
Send help
to other
conversation topics.
Pretty sure it wasn't last episode.
Yeah.
But, yeah. Oh no, this one, I remember really being bad at this.
But it's only backwards now. Oh look, there's a checkpoint.
Cool.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh man.
You know, I'm jealous of people who don't like watching Let's Play videos. Because I'm someone who does watch, you know, like several Let's Play videos.
Right.
And that takes up a lot of my time.
Ah, yes. Okay. I don't watch Let's Play videos as much as I watch, like, certain people play games.
Like, you watch streams, usually, right?
Well, not as much as some people, but I like streamers a lot. A lot of the time, if a streamer has a YouTube channel, actually, I won't even do the Twitch thing.
Okay. Yeah.
But it's something that I could get into.
If I wanted to right now, though, like, I could name several people videos who I watch whose, you know, like, their videos are really long. Because, I mean, like we're doing, it just, like, playing video games can take up a long time.
Yeah.
And they're entertaining videos to watch.
No, we actually could.
I would have so much more free time.
We actually could effectively stream on Twitch if we wanted to.
Yeah, I don't know about that. I mean, we could. I don't understand a lot about Twitch. But basically, I don't want to do that because I just don't watch that much on Twitch. So it's not really, like, my thing. I don't know. We could do it eventually.
Yeah, maybe. Who knows? If we get, like, famous enough.
Or maybe we could stream on Twitch and that would make us famous.
Oh, man. It's like the reverse of what I said. That could work.
Has that happened in any recorded cases about people, like, being discovered on Twitch and then...
There are some
people leading our audience to other stuff.
There are some people who are only famous on Twitch. There are a lot of people who stream and don't really do YouTube stuff, but a lot of the streamers do have YouTube stuff just because they're not always streaming, but YouTube is always there.
Oh. I was like underneath that checkpoint.
Yeah, it should have counted.
So yeah, and then there are the people who like only stream, but then they post the streams on YouTube.
Yeah.
Sometimes as really long, like 2 hour videos,
or
sometimes in
hour.
Like...
Yeah.
Chunks cut up.
Which is not bad.
Yeah. Fun fact that I know because I once watched a series of videos that was uploaded to Twitch. I mean, streamed on Twitch first and then uploaded to YouTube. If it's under 2 hours, if the Twitch stream was under 2 hours, then when you finish streaming on Twitch, you can literally press a button and say, okay, upload this to YouTube.
Oh.
But if it's longer than 2 hours, then you need to, like, you can't just press that button. You need
to
do the editing yourself and stuff.
Oh. Being lazy is so much easier. That's why it's called being lazy.
Mm-hmm.
So how are you doing on this level here?
Not great, although I got past that first part, which is what I remember having trouble with before.
Yeah. So now everything should be easy, right?
Well, I am playing as the Ladybug Ball, which is
nice,
easy,
nice
and
easy.
Nice and easy.
Oh, no!
Oh, I didn't die, though.
Okay, you just gotta do it again.
Nice and
you
easy.
You can do it. Yeah!
Oh, cool! And
then you immediately die.
Yeah, that's what getting checkpoints is for.
Yeah, exactly. That's why they do it in RPGs. It's about to give you a hard boss, have a checkpoint.
Yeah.
Well...
Yeah.
That happened.
Well, in RPGs, it's... I mean, I don't know how much RPGs, you know, give you save points before bosses out of necessity, but more out of, like, the people who play the game would be really frustrated and angry at the game developers if they didn't do that.
Like, every time you die, you have to do the entire, like, dungeon over again. Yeah. It's like, great, now I have to kill those 8 spiders, 9 wolves, and 5 dudes in armor again.
Mm-hmm.
Or if it's an underground dungeon, the 5 skeletons in armor.
Or if it's Pokemon, I need to kill that ice cream.
Yes, that ice cream and that key ring and that sword.
Yes.
Those are like the only 3 really bad Pokemon. Oh, and the trash bag.
I mean, besides Trubbish, which I don't care for as much, all those Pokemon are, I don't know, really good. Especially Klefki and the sword one, whose name I can't believe I can't remember right now. I really like those ones, actually.
Yeah.
I used the sword one.
Aegislash?
Aegislash is like the fully evolved version of it, yeah. Yeah, I used it in my playthrough of X the first time. It was a really good Pokemon.
Lesson learned here. The only good poison Pokemon is Nidoking.
Probably. Was that number 40? Yeah, it was. This video is over, so bye.
Oh, it's the Reef of Noxahegnit.